This video will show you how to assemble the vapor source on the Micromeritics 3-Flex Surface Characterization Analyzer and how to purify the vapor source using the freeze-thaw method. Remember to always consult your operator's manual for more detailed information. The materials you will need are the vapor source, two VCR metal gaskets, dewar, vapor source mantle, vapor source mantle shelf, which is included in the vapor source mantle kit. Additionally, you will need three wrenches, your vapor of interest, and a pipette. A beaker is optional if you wish to use a warm water bath during the thaw process. The vapor source consists of two parts, the vapor reservoir and the vapor shutoff valve. Fill the reservoir with approximately 20 millimeters of a desired liquid with a pipette. If you're using water, use 10 millimeters. Place a VCR metal gasket on the opening of the vapor reservoir and snap it on. Connect the vapor shutoff valve to the reservoir by screwing the connecting nut. Ensure the shutoff valve is closed, positioned horizontally. Ensure the arrow on the back of the shutoff valve is pointing up. Seal the connection by tightening on the gasket with a 3/4 inch and 5/8 inch wrench. On the schematic, all valves should be closed, with the exception of the vacuum to the manifold. Be sure that valve 4 is not open. Now the vapor source is ready to be attached to the instrument. Remove the P0 by unscrewing the connecting nut, using a 3/4 inch wrench, securing the top nut, and another 3/4 inch wrench to unscrew the bottom. Replace the old seal gasket with a new one on the port fitting. The gasket should snap on. Next, mount the vapor source onto the port fitting and tighten it with a 3/4 inch wrench. Double-check the vapor shutoff valve above the liquid-filled reservoir is firmly closed. Open valve 4 on the schematic to evacuate the space above the vapor shutoff valve. Once the space is evacuated sufficiently, when the pressure reading is close to zero, close valve 4 on the schematic and open the shutoff valve. You will notice a pressure increase of several hundred millimeters in mercury on the schematic once the shutoff valve is opened. Now we are ready to start the purification cycle called the freeze-thaw method. Make sure to wear proper personal protective equipment for this step, such as face shield and cryogen gloves. Submerge the vapor reservoir in a cryogen bath by raising the liquid nitrogen-filled dewar manually using the vapor source shelf. Move at a slow pace to prevent liquid nitrogen from splashing. Wait for the pressure in the vapor container to drop as low as possible. This may only be around 100 millimeters of mercury for the first cycle, but the pressure should be near zero after two or three freeze-thaw cycles. Once the pressure stabilizes, indicating the vapor has condensed and frozen, open valve 4 to evacuate the vapor container. Once the pressure reads near zero, open valve 7 to the vacuum gauge for lower pressure readings. Ensure to open valve 7 only when the pressure is near zero and keep it closed before increasing in pressure to prevent any damage. Once the pressure stabilizes, close valve 4 and 7 on the schematic and remove the cryogen bath. Let the reservoir thaw. A gradual increase in pressure on the schematic indicates the vapor thawing. To expedite the process, a warm water bath may be used to raise the temperature of the vapor reservoir. However, a layer of ice formed on the reservoir could also create a barrier for heat transfer, so it is best to not introduce the water bath immediately. When the pressure stabilizes, it indicates the vapor has been thawed. Repeat the freeze-thaw method two more additional cycles until the vapor is free of impurities. Typically, three total freeze-thaw purification cycles are sufficient. After two or three freeze-thaw cycles, pressures in the range of 10 to the negative 4th or 5th millimeters of mercury should be achievable when evacuating over the completely frozen vapor source. When the pressure stabilizes near the actual vapor pressure at room temperature, once the vapor is thawed, the vapor is ready for analysis. Once the purification cycles are completed, slide up the heating mantle on the vapor source and put on the Velcro strap. Finally, secure the mantle in position with the shelf and connect the thermocouple and power source. Now you are ready to use the Micromeritics 3-Flex Surface Characterization Analyzer for vapor analysis. For more information, visit micromeritics.com/learn.